Hi guys, welcome to this video, and hi future me. Remember the first time you set foot on Europe? Well, here's how it went. Enjoy. The red sun witnessed our departure on a warm August evening as we said goodbye to our country that I haven't left since 2.5 years ago. I have been anticipating this whole trip since the beginning of summer, and just arriving at the airport brings back so many nostalgic memories. The line was unexpectedly very long, which shows that we're not the only ones that long for a journey. And now, some airplane montage. Arrived around 8:30 a.m. in Venice, saw our country's flag, we were very emotional. Then we hopped on a bus and went straight to the main island. We were actually carrying all our luggages, and having to tow 20 kg of stuff around the uneven paths was pretty exhausting. But of course that didn't stop us from enjoying the glorious views of Venice. Everything from the buildings to canals, and even to the wooden poles stuck in the water, gave off a certain vibe that was beauty to us. We immediately got some gelato because it's a must.
Thank you.
Strode around St. Mark's Square, admiring the elegance of the buildings and appreciating the historical culture that we had the chance to see. Later, we found a place to eat. The manager of the restaurant was extremely nice. Despite our language barriers, he kept giving us free bruschetta. I must say it was the best bruschetta I had on this trip. After lunch, we saw our country's exhibition for Venice Biennale 2022, and we got emotional. Again. Ours was simple and quite small. Nonetheless, we are still proud of it.
Freedom.
Got stolen something like 5 minutes ago.
Yep, luckily one of our parents were quick enough to grab the sealer's hand, and only the bag was opened.
This is our bed.
Where's the TV?
They don't have it. This is our TV. There's only one channel. This building was made in 1836, which is ancient. Really cool.
Visited the Ponte della Dogana, redesigned by Tadao Ando, which was showcasing Bruce Naman's contrapposto studies. The entire exhibition surrounded a man walking while maintaining the contrapposto pose. There was a human performance, different medias. And repetitive sound effects. hope it's pizza. In the end, we did get pizza.
Got a second ice cream, lemon flavored this
time. After finishing pizzas that were bigger than our faces, we concluded our first day in Venice by falling right asleep. We started our second day with some coffee and croissant. As usual, the food was really good. Around 8:30, we took the boat and sailed to another island. When it's early in the morning, there's less people trying to take public transport, so we got to see outside to enjoy the sun and the breeze. But beware of the Italy flag on the end of the boat, because there's a high chance that you'll be slapped by it. After endless minutes in the sun, we arrived at Burano.
We have arrived in Burano.
Strolling around Murano, we went to the island of Murano, best known for its exquisite blown glass. We both bought some glass jewels that look like ones from Pandora, and then sat down to enjoy lunch. Later during noon, we got back to the main island, got some gelato, and an iced lemon drink to cool off the heat. Then we got on the boat again to head over to Lido Island, which we spent the whole afternoon playing in the waveless sea. This was our dinner, and if you ever come, you must try this. And after dinner, we went back to our Airbnb. Today was our last day in Venice, and we were lucky enough to see rain.
It's raining. And we don't have umbrellas. Yay.
It eventually stopped raining and we went up St. Mark's Tower to enjoy the view. There were surprisingly a bunch of cats. For the rest of the afternoon, we went to an international cultural exhibition, better known as the Venice Biennale 2022. It was amazing seeing all the artworks displayed by multiple countries in one area. And if you were to go, never try to finish it in one day like us. The whole exhibition showcased different problems or aspects of society, most of them centering around the idea of humans and Earth. My personal favorite was France exhibition, mainly because you get to see cool props and feel immersed. There were galleries that showcased not only visual art, but music and sounds as well. South Korea had a cool combination of science and technology. Japan made you feel like you're in the void with deep voices and laser beams. Some were creepy and we were traumatized. Not this one, but one had a bloody video and another had naked guys doing something to a tree. Now we're just pretending that we never saw that. And that concludes our 3 days in Venice. 3 days went by so fast, it barely felt real. But looking back at the photos we took, we know that it was a special memory that'll remain in our hearts forever. Mostly because, right when we got off the bus, our phone got stolen.